Aviation English. Aviation English is the de facto language of civil aviation called radio telephony. It is a specialized communication which is used by pilots and air traffic controllers and other personnel who are associated with the aviation industry. This communication happens completely over radio frequencies, the radio channel, and there is no face-to-face communication between the different interlocutors. Like other areas of ESP, it uses the conventional English forms, and some of the grammar, the vocabulary, and so on, but then it combines them with specialist language of the of this particular area and this domain and context. So the language of air traffic control is a hybrid language which combines together the specialized technical language which is associated with the aviation industry and the conventional English or other languages. This language has been officially mandated by the ICAO, the International Civil Aviation Agency, which is a specialized agency of the United Nations. The ICAO mandates that pilots and air traffic controllers must have proficiency at the level of 4 in the aviation English in order to become effective communicators of English. Because it has become a miscommunication between the pilots and other personnel, and the air traffic controllers particularly has become the cause of many air traffic accidents. So the ICAO mandates that pilots and air traffic controllers must have a comprehensible pronunciation. They must have fluency in their delivery. They must be able to paraphrase their communication in certain situations, and they must have the essential vocabulary which they need in order to communicate. So there are two concepts which are important to understand in regards to aviation English. One is that it uses a particular kind of a phraseology, which is a prescribed syntax and vocabulary for use. And then there is plain English, that is the non-prescribed use of common English vocabulary and syntax. So these two concepts are very important for the business English teacher and learner to understand. So the characteristics of aviation and discourse are that it uses a restricted syntax. The grammar which it uses mostly uses the verbs which are in the imperative form, and the use of functional words is limited. Like, for example, prepositions can be used, but pronouns and modal auxiliaries are completely eliminated. Then it uses a specialized vocabulary. For example, numbers are used in a certain way. Letters are important, which are always used with single digits. Five is called five, pronounced as five, and three is always pronounced as tree. The words are pronounced in a certain way. For example, P is pronounced as Papa and R is pronounced as Romeo, just as in maritime and in military contexts. So these numbers are also prescribed, and the ICAO alphabet is used. The interactional rules of exchange, that the use of the common language, plain English, is prohibited. Discourse which the pilot usually has can be divided into steps which he has with the air traffic controller. First of all, in the exchange starts with identifying his addressee, whom he is addressing, which is the air traffic controller. After this, he identifies himself. Then he informs the air traffic controller about the flight level. And this language needs to be shared. The frequency and the level needs to be shared, because this leads to a critical situational awareness about the position and the direction of both the interlocutors. For the air traffic controller, the discourse can be divided again into steps. First of all, he identifies the aircraft. Then he identifies himself, his location, and then acknowledges the receipt of the information which the pilot has given to him or her, and then passes instructions to the pilot to proceed, and then again contact the controller when he reaches the point where he has been directed. The pilot repeats this whole conversation, which is called readback, and then concludes by saying the call sign. So the use of plain English is prohibited in aviation English in the interaction between the pilot and the controller. Non-prescribed phraseology, which is plain English, cannot be used. This causes problem with the non-native speakers, the pilots or the air traffic controller, if one of the interlocutor uses plain English. This can cause serious situations. Use of the full text, full syntax is also prohibited. And usually it is seen that when pilots are under stress or in emergency situations, then they resort to the use of full syntax and plain English. So non-prescribed syntax causes problems of miscommunication, especially where there are non-native speakers of English involved.